Hello. Are you there, Mr. Muhammad?
I'm here.
All right. How I can help you, my friend? Do you have a comment about what we said?
I want to explain why you were very afraid in the last call to let the people speak, to let the people hear what I was saying.
I'm very afraid always. Go ahead, make me afraid again.
I wish to explain that I have made a video on the channel with full subtitles. You will find it on Answers to Christians.
Okay, and?
And this video has explained all of these.
Why you don't explain to us here? You know, why Muslims, they get spanked in my when they call me, and then they later they make a video to explain how the spanking happened. Explain, defend yourself. Here we go. Go ahead.
Okay, but you made, I want to speak about, I want to ask you a question. Would you accept a prophecy after Jesus or would you not accept it?
A prophecy after Jesus?
Yes.
Well, I made a prophecy yesterday. Yesterday I said there is somebody is going to have an accident in the highway.
Would you accept a prophet after Jesus if he comes with evidence or would you not accept him?
Well, evidence? Okay, what evidence? Show me. Go ahead. I'm not going to accept a prophet without telling me what is the evidence, who is the prophet. I mean, you want me to accept just to accept? If you can show me something good, let us see. Go ahead.
And don't you claim that prophecy is known through evidence?
My friend, somebody, he is a prophet. He have to provide in the Bible, give us a category for a prophet. He have to prophesy in the name of the true God, and his prophet, and his prophecy have to come to be true. If you miss one of them, you are a false prophet. Go ahead.
طيب, you said that Muhammad and Jesus they were different. They were Muhammad. Jesus is the truth, whereas Muhammad is a liar.
Muhammad is not a liar. Muhammad is a lying manufacturer.
طيب, you claimed that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Muhammad he was looking for the world, whereas when you look at his biography, you find that he didn't care about this world for the least. All he cared about was that people say la ilaha illallah, that they worship the one.
Really? So why Muhammad? Why Muhammad? He owned many slaves and he have many wives, and why he asked for the fifth of every attack from the booty? Why the Muslims accuse him of stealing underwear? Do you have an answer?
I can tell you that slavery was acceptable before Muhammad.
Yeah, but why he owned slaves? Why he don't care for the world, as you said? No problem. I understand. At that time, it was accepted. No problem. But why? Yes. Why he want to have more and more slaves? If he don't care for the world, why he don't say, okay, all the slaves go free. I don't want to slaves. I don't want money. Did your prophet say, if you want to meet me to speak with me in a private, you have to pay me? Yes or no?
He didn't say that. No.
Do you want to? You want to bet?
The Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, he told, my friend, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Allah told him. Well, I can say, okay.
Yes.
Allah told him to get money for seeing people. That's clear.
Allah told the believers,
my friend.
Allah told the
yeah, told the believer. But who is the one who told the believers? Muhammad. What is the proof that this is Allah? Why Allah he care if Muhammad get money? Why Muhammad get money? Here we go. You are talking to me. Did I ask you for a private consultation?
Listen, Prince.
Listen, my friend. Listen, my friend. Listen. Don't run away. Don't run away. I am here. I am here. Guys, how many hours today I stayed with you? How many hours? 6 hours in the morning or five? And now God knows how many hours. Did I ask you for money? Why Muhammad is a prophet of God? I'm not a prophet. I'm just a normal human being. I'm no one.
Allah.
Why Muhammad? Don't tell me Allah. Don't tell me Allah. Why Allah he care? Why Allah he care? That a prophet of God, if he want to meet somebody in a private, he have to be paid.
Who paid the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
My friend, your prophet, he do not need to be paid if he is coming from God, because God will provide him.
Yes, and that's
you do not need to make it an obligation for everybody when I meet him in a private to pay him. Read with me. Oh, who you believe when you consult with the messenger in private, spend something.
That is correct.
He's asking in advance, my friend. No, no. You see, anyone can talk to me. Anyone can talk to me. People, they talk to me. I answer hundreds of emails. I make thousands of videos. I never ask anyone to pay me a penny. I am not a prophet. Your prophet should have a better ethic than me. Why he make a condition? Why Jesus? Listen. Why Jesus did not say? You see, my voice is not good. Why Jesus did not say, okay, pay me before you see me?
The Prophet
said, why Moses did not do the same?
Can you let me ask the question just so we can have a dialogue?
Mm.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, he was told to tell his people, I do not ask you for anything, for any gain. I'm not asking you for any payment.
What are you asking? He's asking. Okay, did Allah say the fifth of every booty to the Prophet, yes or no?
That is correct, but did the Prophet take anything from it?
He took it, for sure he took it. Here we go, the Muslims are fighting over an underwear. Don't you see, don't you read with me? The Muslims accuse your Prophet. Read with me, my friend, I'm not making things up. Is that a true story or not, that the Muslims are fighting over the booty, accusing your Prophet that he took an underwear?
Yani, you are being very, very dishonest. Yeah,
my friend, the proof in front of you, the screen, I don't care if you are in YouTube, if you are in the moon, you keep saying to me dishonest, I'm showing the proof and the reference. This is Tafsir al-Jalalain. This is chapter 1, verse number 161. The Muslims accused the Prophet that he stole a bikini. So why you say to me you are being dishonest?
I just want you to understand, Christian Prince, that you have to take it objectively. You are thinking about things in a very wrong way, and I can just point out to you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Jesus, Jesus and Muhammad, they were brothers. They were brothers in faith. You cannot, you are like what you are. Seeing something which is not there, and you are just lying to the people. This is not
okay. You are being a potato now, and you don't show us I'm lying about what. Show us I lied about what. Did the Muslims accuse your prophet to be fraud? Yes or no?
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Sahaba and the companions of the
yes,
Prophet,
accuse him to be fraud. Yes, no, this is a lie. Here we go, guys. Does it say in the front of me? Does it say in the front of you in the interpretation of the verse that he accused him to be a fraud? Do you see the word of fraud?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does this mean? Does this mean that he did take anything?
Well, you tell me if I am a prophet and my companion accuse me to be fraud, what about the strangers? If the one who believe in Muhammad accuse him to be fraud, that means he's a fraud.
Nobody accused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Maybe a few.
Who is the few? Obviously, your God Allah in His throne, He decided to write about it that Muhammad, he stole an underwear. I mean, what kind of God? Let me ask you. Your God Allah, He did not write us. I'm not listening. Listen, you wait. Let me prove to you that you are trying to escape the truth. Did your prophet have sex with 6 years old girl? Yes. Did your prophet kidnap women from their houses? Yes. Did he steal money? Yes. Did he torture a Jew guy for asking him for the money he hid under the ground, which is his money? Yes. Did Muhammad, he cut a woman two pieces when she was alive just because she made a poetry against him? Yes. She is 85 years old. What kind of a prophet he is, the one you have? What kind of a man? He cut a woman two pieces when she's alive and she is 85 years old. Where is the mercy? Where is the ethic?
Islam is the highest ethic.
What is the ethic? Here we go. Okay. Is it the ethic to have sex with 6 years old girl?
He did not have that. When she was 9, he married her.
Is that better?
He married her when she was 6 and he entered into her when she was
9.
Okay,
he married her at the age of 6, so he was molesting her between 6 to 9, and at 9 he have intercourse with her. What kind of a man? He is at the age of 54, he marries a 6 years old girl.
Why is this against the Prophet? I don't
because
see at all
that means he's a pedophile, because this is ethic. This is not marriage. This is not marriage. She's a child. In order to marry somebody, she have to agree to marry you.
In order to marry someone,
she don't even know what marriage means. Do a child in the age of 6, she know what marriage means?
There are certain cases where this.
My friend, there is someone saying to me, 9 years old. No, she was not 9 years old. Stop being a fool. She is 6 years old when he married her.
He entered into her when she was
no,
nine.
He molested her between the age of 6 to 9, and at the age of 9 he have intercourse. At the age of 9 he have intercourse. Now let me ask you, if she is not ready, why a man at the age of 54?
Why are you bringing up these things? We have to
because you are ashamed of it. This is why you don't want to talk about it. Why? I mean, why? Because we're talking about the ethic of your prophet. Let us talk about different ethic. Let us talk about different ethic. Did Muhammad enter the house of his own son and he flirt with the wife when she is married to him? Did he or not? Say no. I challenge you. I challenge you to say no. What foundation? What kind of foundation? A prophet of God, he entered to the house of his own son when the son is not there and he flirt with the wife.
The Prophet was the highest moral character.
What highest? If your father, be honest, if your father enter your house and he flirt with your wife, is he a highest person? Or he's a scumbag.
This is inconceivable of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi.
What inconceivable? What kind of a prophet? Answer me. Why he did that? Explain to me why he did that. Why he flirted with the married women?
I wanted to.
No, answer me. Why he flirted with? Give me a logical explanation. He is a high ethic. He is the best of mankind. He is the best of people. But he entered a house of the husband, which is his son, and he flirted with the wife, and he said to her loud, with a loud voice, my heart is a flipping for you. Praise be to Allah. My heart is beating for you. I want you. What kind of man he say that? What kind of a man? Okay, here we go. Let me show you. Guys, he said to bring the hadith itself, right? The second I will show it to him, he will say, I don't believe in this. So just wait. Hold on.
It has to be.
Hold on.
Not necessarily. Authentic.
Yeah. Authentic, it's your books. Nothing in your book is authentic anyway.
My friend,
nothing in your books is authentic. Nothing in your book is authentic. The Quran is not authentic. The Hadith is not authentic. Muhammad is not authentic. Allah is not authentic. So why are you asking for something authentic? All of you is not authentic. Listen. And you are the one who said it have to be authentic. And this is a proof that Islam is a false religion. Because why you Muslims have books are not authentic about the Prophet? Because you Muslims are liars. Otherwise,
no,
you tell me.
It is because we Muslims, we narrated everything, the lies and the good things.
You narrated the lies about your prophet. I mean, this is a wonderful job. And let me ask you a question. Did your prophet say, don't write hadith about me?
We transmitted everything.
Did your prophet say, don't write the hadith about me? Yes or no?
He did say that.
Okay, so why you write the hadith?
Because you don't understand what is the context.
No,
the
tell
context
me. No, why you write the hadith?
I want to have a dialogue just to make sure that you understand. If you are honest, you will come to the truth. If you are dishonest, people will find out the truth. You should care about the truth. So let us speak.
My friend, I'm letting you speak. I'm asking you. Why the prophet he said don't write the hadith and you Muslim write the hadith? Who is a stupid here?
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there are now many points. Can we go into them one by one?
Yeah, we just go to the one about your prophet flirting with the Zainab.
Bring the hadith itself.
All right.
Put it on YouTube.
All right, let us see.
And I just want to clarify that I'm not a sheikh, because
I don't care.
I'm not a sheikh.
My friend, I don't care if you're a sheikh or not. Who cares? This is not the last of my worry.
But I care that.
What
you don't
are you? Are you preparing yourself to say that you are? You know nothing. You know, is that
no.
What? Okay.
Alhamdulillah, I am on light from Allah. I'm on guidance.
Okay.
You are in error.
Okay.
But we have to have dialogue so that we reach.
All right. All right. Okay. Here we go. Let us go. You have the Quran with you.
I told you I memorized the Quran.
Okay. Which chapter in the Quran speak about Zayd? Which verse?
فَلَمَّا قَدَى زَيْدٌ مِنْهُ وَطَرًا الْأَحْزَابِ the sixth page.
The Ahzab what?
Sixth page.
What sixth page? No, which verse?
I don't remember.
Hmm?
I don't remember. فلما قضى زيد منها وطن
منصور. All right, all right. So this is a chapter 33, verse number 37. We will go to the interpretation. I will make you read with me. So you don't say I'm making things up. All right. All right. Let us see. Read with me this one in the screen. Do you see it?
One second, where is the hadith? Yes, okay, one second. Just a second, because I'm working from YouTube. It's on the screen now?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I don't see it yet, one second. Yes, now I see it. طيب.
Read and translate for us, please.
طيب, what is this? One second. Where did you get this? One second. قلت هذا القدر الذي أخرجه مسلم في صحيحه. Okay, can you go up just a little bit up so I can read the from the beginning a little bit? Go up. I don't see. Yeah, one second.
This is Tafsir Jami al Ahkam al Quran al Qurtubi. All right.
Yes.
All right. Okay. Go down. Read for me and translate.
Okay, type. First of all, tafsir is not all of it authentic.
Read for me. Yeah, it's a lie.
One second.
It's a lie.
Uh-huh. I haven't read it to say it's a lie or not.
All right, right.
I'm saying that tafsir, not all tafsir.
Right.
To know the authenticity of narration, we have to go into the sanad. We have to know go into the chain of narrators.
Uh-huh.
Are the narrators honest? Are the narrators with good memory? And if we know this, we can come to
my friend. Go to the topic. Read for me and translate. Let everybody
know.
Okay, read and tell us what happened.
Yes. تقول الذي أنعم الله عليه وأنعمت عليه. أمسك عليك زوجك تقرأ. قلت هذا القدر الذي أخرجه مسلم في صحيحه. What is the قدر? There's something before it. Can you go up?
My friend, read the one I highlight for you. The riwaya, the story. Not the rest.
إن زيدًا
تورم ذلك منه حين أراد أن يقربها. Read.
One second. قلت هذا القدر الذي أخرجه مسلم في صحيحه وهو الذي صححه الترمذي في جامعه وفي البخاري عن أنس بن مالك هذه الآية تخفي في نفسك ما الله مبديه نزلت في شأن زينب بنت جحش وزينب بن حارث وزيد بن حارثة وقال عمر وابن مسعود وعائشة والحسن ما أنزل الله على رسوله آية أشد عليه من هذه الآية. طيب وقال الحسن وعائشة لو كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كاتما شيئا من الوحي لكتم هذه الآية بشدته عليه. يعني what is he saying here? He is saying that
my friend, all of this you read for me is not important. My friend, no, just retrieve the story for me. Does it say here? You see, I'm trying to avoid the story. Read the story. Read the story. أنه أمسى زيد فأوى إلى فراشه قالت زينب ولم يستطعني زيد. Read. Go ahead and translate.
وروي في الخبر أنه أمسى زيد فروي في الخبر. What is the خبر? What does خبر mean?
Oh.
What does it mean? It means a report.
Yeah, isn't it all of it?
What about
isn't it Islam? All of it is report. Isn't it the Hadith is a report? Isn't the Quran is a report? What's wrong with you?
I'm not afraid of
okay, read for us. Why you keep true. Why you keep doing blah 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 blah? You don't want to read. Why you are afraid? Read. Yeah, let everybody laugh. Read. Let everybody laugh. You are in trouble. You are in trouble. You will not read it. Prove to me you are not afraid. Read. Continues.
Read.
Just read. Just read and translate. Read and translate. And after you finish reading and translating, explain. Go ahead.
وروي في الخبر أنه أمسى زيد but you promise me you give me time to explain.
I'm listening. Go ahead.
وروي في الخبر أنه أمسى زيد فآوى إلى فراشه قالت زينب ولم يستطعني زيد وما امتنع منه غير ما منعه الله مني.
Translate please. Translate step by step.
فلا يقدر علي.
Step by step. Step by step. Translate.
طيب I have to understand first.
طيب.
أمسى زيد فآوى إلى فراشه قالت زينب ولم يستطعني زيد وما امتنع منه وما امتنع I will get the original, please. One second, because there's something wrong. وَمَنْ تَمَعَ
Let us make it simple, my friend. It's going to take you 10 hours to read it, and suddenly you do not know Arabic. Suddenly you do not know Arabic. Suddenly he need to understand, guys. Suddenly, so why you don't read? Why you are giving it all this time? Does it? Let us make it short. Does it make short? Does Zainab says that Zaid he wanted to have sex with me, and Allah did not allow him to have sex? Yes or no?
وما امتنع منه وما امتنع منه غير ما منعه الله منه.
Yeah, does it say that? Do you agree?
فلا يقدر عليه.
Yeah, do you agree that he tried to sleep with her, but Allah did not let him able to do it? Correct.
هذه رواية أبو عاصم.
My friend, does it say that or not?
Possible.
But no, it doesn't say possible. It is. This is what it says. Don't lie.
Probably.
Don't say properly. This is what it says in front of your eyes. Stop lying.
I don't know.
But what do you mean? No. It's in the front of you.
Because there is.
It's in the front of you. Now, as long you we put you in the corner. Now, how Allah made the man not able to have sex with Zainab? Can you explain to us?
It seems as if he was unable.
Yeah. Why? How? What happened? Explain. Read the rest.
لا استغفر الله وما امتنع منه غير ما منعه الله مني
وما امتنع منه let me teach you Arabic man what's wrong with you are you sure you know Arabic let me read for you shut up let me read for you Arabic man you do not know how to read Arabic you are repeating the same sentence for the last 15 minutes and you keep repeating no and you claim that you know Arabic and you know Quran by heart وما امتنع منه غير ما منعه الله مني فلا يقدر علي هذه رواية أبو عصمة نوح بن أبي مريم رفع حديث إلى زينب إن أنها قد قالت ذلك وفي بعض الروايات أن زيدا تورم ذلك منه حين أراد أن يقربها translate
يقربها okay this means that she was staying away from him this is what I understand
my friend does it say there that his penis became swallowing each time he tried to have sex with her Allah he made his penis swell
One second. وما أمتنع منه غير من الله مني فلا يقدر عليه. هذه رواية أبي عاصم رحمه الله مريم ورفع الحديث إلى زينب ورفع الحديث إلى زينب أنها قالت ذلك. She said that about herself.
And it says here أن زيدا.
وفي بعض الروايات. One second. وفي بعض الروايات. In other narrations. Of course, these are narrations. We have to verify. Are they correct narrations or incorrect narrations? Are they authentic or inauthentic? We don't just accept. Of course. أن زيدا تورم ذلك منه حين أراد أن يقربها.
Translate.
This means that he was unable.
Don't lie. This is not doesn't what it says.
أن زيدا تورم ذلك منه.
Doesn't say that. It says يقربها. It says Allah he made his penis swell.
No, it doesn't say that. It, said,
it says تورم. تورم. What تورم mean? Translate. What the word تورم mean? Stop being a liar.
تورم means something swells.
Yeah. So what is that swell? His lips or his penis?
Yes, you are correct. Correct.
So let me ask you, why Allah he made the penis of the husband swell because Muhammad he flirt with the women?
Speak well, please. We are trying to arrive at.
I'm speaking well, my friend. Okay. The story in front of you. I'm not the one who's using the word penis here. It's there. So
it doesn't say penis.
It says it tawarrama dhalika minhu. Speaking about the penis.
Where is the word?
Penis? What is tawarrama? Yes, why they are talking about what he cannot have sex? Why they cannot have sex? Because it's a swell. What is a swell? It's his penis. Be honest.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. So now explain to us why Allah he made the penis of the husband a swell just because Muhammad he flirt with the wife.
Christian prince, when we speak terms, we speak in good ways. We don't use fahish.
Are you saying the word penis is fahish?
The way you are saying it is in a very.
Isn't it your prophet? He says the one who is proud about his father. Go and tell him to bite the his father penis.
That is correct in a very 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 extreme.
It's correct,
sense.
Guys. Did you hear? It's correct. So we have a prophet. We have a prophet. He said to people, "Go and bite the penis of your father."
Prince,
and he is saying to me, "Don't use the word penis." What kind of a prophet? He said, "Go and bite the penis of your father." You said that, not me. Everybody heard you. You said this is correct. What kind of a prophet?
Say that?
Doesn't matter. What kind of a prophet? He said that.
He never used any rude words. The Prophet sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
No, he said that if a person comes and trying to bloat about himself and say, "I am the son of this person, I am the son of that person," trying to make discord and make enmity between people, like saying, "I am better than you, I'm better than you." He said, "A'adduhu ayr abi," let him tell him by.
Thank you, guys. He just said the word ayr, which mean, excuse my language, the word dick, exactly, not even penis. I'm being polite saying the word penis. Look what happened now. You just said, if somebody is proud about his family, tell him to go and buy the dick of his penis. But isn't your prophet in the hadith isn't it your prophet he said, "I am from a Hashim, and Hashim are the best"?
No, the Prophet says, "Wala fakhra," and there is no
pride. No, hold on. No, he said, he chose me from the best. He called all the tribes, and he said, and the best of all the tribe is Hashim, and I am the best of Hashim. You want to show the hadith? So we should.
He is the best of Hashim. Yes.
Should we say to Muhammad, go and buy the penis of your father?
Let us go back to the topic.
Listen.
You will have to let me address this.
Okay, address this.
You're being dishonest. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ever felt proud of his lineage in this way, as you say. He never at all told the people, "I am the son of Kada, I am better than you because of that." Yani in the sense that he is making. He is being arrogant. The Prophet ﷺ was very humble when he entered Mecca. He was extremely humble when he conquered Mecca. He entered into it with his head bowed down, He was saying.
And he ordered to kill women and men who they were accusing him to be false prophet.
He forgave everyone in Mecca, okay, except for 10 people.
10 people, who are they? 10 people? There's women between them.
Yes.
So
they were of the worst of God's creatures, just like you.
So why are you saying those are his family, still he wanna kill them? 10 people from his family. This is Quraysh, this is his tribe. So what is the favor he do if he don't kill his family? In the top of that, he want to kill his family still. Now we go
because
back to the topic.
Abdul,
what right of Allah? You see, your prophet is a perverted man. Here we go. He claimed, Muhammad, he went to the house of his own son. He flirted with the wife. And then because he flirted, Allah, he was listening. So the man, he came back home. He wanted to sleep with his wife. Allah, he did bite the penis of the husband, and he made him his penis as well. So now he cannot sleep with her. Explain to us, what kind of miracle is that?
I want to say that I'm not aware whether you are muting me or you're letting me, the people are hearing what I'm saying.
Everybody hear you.
Have to make sure. Yeah. Because maybe last time, many of the things I was saying, they were not there.
People, they hear you. Look at the YouTube, people will hear you. They are laughing. That's why they are laughing. So now, why Allah, he made the penis? Let me repeat the question for you. Yeah. Why Allah made the penis of the husband as well? Explain to us this amazing miracle.
It doesn't say it's a miracle. It says it is something which
it says that the one who did that is Allah.
It doesn't say that.
Who is the one who forbid him? Who is the one that did not allow him to do it? It's Allah. She said that in front of you. You claim to speak Arabic, don't you?
Tawarrama doesn't mean it swells necessarily.
Don't lie. Tawarrama, it means it swells, and you are the one who translate.
It means that he's unable, probably. This one,
Abdul, you see. If I show it to you in the dictionary right now, are you willing to open the camera and do the monkey dance for us?
The dictionary is lying. No, the Google dictionary is not.
But not Google dictionary. If I show you an official dictionary, what do you do? You see, you are a liar. You are a certified liar. Shame on you.
I am telling you, I don't know this hadith. I'm willing to look into
my friend. You don't know. You are learning from a Christian prince. Admit that I am your master. I am the one who teach you Islam. Each time a Muslim called me, he said, "I never heard this before. Donkeys, how you believe in God? You never heard this before. What kind of a Muslim? He did not learn this before. Why you are learning from a Christian person? not learning from the Muslims.
Not even in the Sahih.
It is. It is in your.
My friend.
Abdul. Does it say in front of you that or not? This is not my problem. Does it say that?
There are many narrations which are lies.
Okay, go.